be consistent with it, and you see your hair will begin to soften up and grow really
You know,
well.
Before you comb your hair, you need to make sure that it has lots of moisture in it.
Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, guys, I'm going to be doing a requested video by one of my subscribers. It's been a long time since I did a natural hair video. I'm gonna keep doing that on my channel now over and over again because I started this channel with a natural hair. This particular person wants to know how to soften your natural hair, although I already have a video of that. I'm gonna link it down comment section down below. After watching this video, you can go and watch that. So by the time you watch both videos, you're going to gain a lot from it. Guys, before this video, I'd like to say thank you to all my wonderful subscribers. If you're watching me for the first time, you're welcome to this channel. My name is Rebecca and friends call me Becky. I upload lots of informative videos on this channel, DIYs, vlogs, anything that comes, anything at all. I also upload my natural hair journey channel. Okay, so you're welcome to this channel. Be sure to hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, share this video to friends and family, and also be supportive, okay? I'm doing a requested video today, like I said, about how to soften natural hair. I've done that video before. I'm going to link it down again. Go and watch that video, okay? But I'm also going to shed more light to that video. I need you to understand how to do this very, very well. Okay, yeah, people give up on natural hair easily because of the texture of our hair. It's hard. Naturally, our hair texture is very, very hard to maintain. If you do what you're supposed to do, your hair is going to remain soft. My hair is really, really soft because I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. I'm giving it the kind of moisture that it needs. One thing that you want to make sure that you do to your hair is moisture. Moisturizing your hair on a daily basis is something that you want to incorporate into a regimen. Do it every day. Moisturize your hair on a daily basis. How do you do this? In this video, I'm going to be telling you what you're going to be doing on a weekly basis, on a daily basis, and a monthly basis to get your hair soft. You cannot keep your natural hair soft if you're the lazy type. But if you really want to get that soft natural hair, you can get it. What you want to do on a daily basis is moisturize your hair. There are tons of videos on YouTube on how you can moisturize your natural hair. You can just, you know, type it in and how to moisturize natural hair. You get a lot of tips from other YouTubers. I think I have a video of how you can moisturize your hair. I'm going to link that video in the comment section as well. Okay, so on a daily basis, what you want to do is that you want to give your hair the kind of moisture it deserves. Okay, so there are ways you can moisturize your hair. You can moisturize your hair by using the LOC method, the LOC method, or the LCO method. I think there are other methods as well, but I'm used to LOC method, which is the leave-in oil and cream. I just made a video of natural hair spray. You get a section, you spray it, you follow on with your oil, you use your cream. My cream is my shea butter. I also have a video of how you can prepare your shea butter mix. I will link the video down in the comment section below as well. So use that butter to seal in all the moisture. Twist your hair into when you want to go to bed. Use your satin scarf. Tie your hair really nice, not too tight, just to make sure your hair is protected. Or if you don't want to tie your hair, you can get a silky pillowcase and sleep on it. Never you go to bed with your hair not moisturized or maybe with your hair exposed. Don't ever use a cotton pillowcase on your natural hair. Our hair doesn't like that. A cotton pillowcase is going to get the moisture out of your hair and it will become dry the next day, which your hair doesn't really like. So the best thing is to get your hair moisturized and also protected at night. So that is that about the daily thing. So let's talk about the weekly routine. What you're going to be doing every week is getting your hair deep conditioned. Okay, you must deep condition your hair every week. Get your hair deep conditioned, get a good deep conditioner, and do a deep treatment mask. You cannot skip deep treatment mask. It's very, very important. If you want your hair to be soft, you have to incorporate all this. You need to have a regimen. You can't just ignore your hair. It will remain hard. It will remain difficult to manage. You don't want all of that. You won't even like your natural hair if it's really hard. Weekly basis, do a deep treatment mask. If I have that video, I'm also going to link it down how to deep condition your hair. I'm going to link it down in the comment section below as well. Tons of videos of how to deep condition your hair on YouTube. You can just, you know, check those videos out and just, you know, build a regimen, you know, just be consistent. Consistency is the key. Doing it today, maybe doing it this month, and next month you're not doing anything, you know, it's not going to work that way, okay? So be consistent with whatever you're doing. Continue like that, just like having your bath. Make it as a weekly, daily routine and just
you know, be consistent with it. And you see your hair will begin to soften up and grow really well, really healthy and soft. So number three thing you want to do is a monthly thing. Every month, according to me, I do a protein treatment. Make sure you do a protein treatment because you don't want to have a moisture overload. Okay, you want to be able to balance between moisture and protein. So some people do protein treatments like twice every week. They do it twice a month. Okay, it depends on what your hair wants. If you think your hair loves protein, then do the protein treatment twice every month. You know the kind of thing your hair wants. Like I said, consistency is the key. If you're very consistent with all this, your hair will do well. And lady also said she cannot comb her hair. Please, natural hair does not need combing. Okay, you don't need to comb natural hair. Why would you want to comb your natural hair? Leave it the way it is. Moisture will tell. Okay, when you moisturize your hair, where your hair will soften up. If you want to comb your hair, you must use a wide tooth comb. Like this is the kind of comb that I will advise you to use on your natural hair. It must be a wide tooth comb, not the one that's got a thin one. This kind of comb is a no, or the thin penciled, you know, those. I don't even have it. You know, there is another one that is thinner than this because I feel I don't need it. I don't use that such kind of comb here. It's not needed. While you comb your hair, you need to make sure that it has lots of moisture in it. Hair is well conditioned. Maybe you have lots of conditioner on your hair and you want to detangle your hair, or maybe your hair is, you know, it has lots of moisture. You know, your hair can really take this comb, you know, in. Not you forcing, you know, your hair, trying to comb your hair out really hard. And, you know, her hair does not need to be combed. Her hair does not need all those kind of things. You know, you need to get your hair really moisturized before combing it. If your hair is not soft enough, please, please, please do not comb your hair. Your hair does not need combing. Even some people, they've stayed years and years and years without combing their hair. Another thing I want to say is that watch lots of natural hair videos. Don't just say, I want to keep my natural hair, and you just are keeping it. You don't know how to maintain it. You don't know how to keep it. It's going to look very weird, okay? Watch lots of videos on natural hair. How do I care for my natural hair and stuff like that. Watch those videos on YouTube. Nobody is born with it, you know. Everybody learn it, okay? You need to learn it as well. You need to be able to take care of your natural hair. And I tell you, just enjoy it, okay? Enjoy it while you care for your hair. Don't feel lazy about it. Don't get tired about it. Don't feel reluctant, okay? Just do it. Do what you're supposed to do on a daily basis. Do what you're supposed to do on a weekly basis. Do what you're supposed to do on a monthly basis. Another thing you can do to soften your natural hair is co-wash. Okay, what is co-wash? Co-wash is a method of using just a conditioner to wash your hair without a shampoo, okay? Use just the conditioner in the bathroom. Just use it to work it on your hair. And some people do this like twice a week. Some people do it once in a week, maybe in between the week. Maybe like Tuesdays or Wednesdays. They just do it. They just go wash their hair, wash their scalp, work the conditioner into their hair, and their hair just becomes soft. The more you do this, gradually your hair will be softening up. Also learn how to do a pre-poo. A pre-poo is a situation whereby you use oil, like coconut oil or olive oil. You just warm it up and, you know, just drench it on your hair. Just put it on your hair, you know, just put on a heat cap and just stay on the heat, you know, for a few minutes, 15 minutes or so, and then remove it before using the shampoo on your hair. The answer to this is just watch tons and tons of YouTube videos about natural hair. You are going to gain a lot from it. I've given you a lot of tips. I don't think there's anything more to say regarding this. And just that about this video. Don't ever think of using comb on your hair when it is dry. You don't need all of that. Your hair doesn't need it. You're going to damage your scalp. You're going to damage your hair. You're going to lose more hair than you're getting, okay? You see a lot of hair coming out of the comb, and you don't want all of that, okay? So you need to keep your hair protected. You need to, at night, you go on your satin scarf or get a satin pillowcase. Don't ever put your hair on a cotton pillowcase. It is not advisable, okay? So by the time you do all of that, I assure you, your hair is going to grow. Your hair is going to become soft. And also take care of your inside as well. That is the number one thing. Take care of your inside. Eat good food. Eat healthy food. Live a healthy lifestyle. Drink lots and lots of water. Gosh, just go on YouTube, because even if I start today, I'm not going to finish it. It's a lot you need to learn about natural hair. All right, just enjoy it. Just learn it. The more you learn, the more you know, okay? And just, you know, if you're not making your research, you're never going to know. Make research about natural hair. And the more you make research, the more you know, okay? So, I hope I've been able to share enough information on how to soften your natural hair. Share this video to friends and family. Share this video to anyone that is trying to grow out their natural hair. And also, stay supportive. Thank you so much to all my wonderful subscribers. Thank you so much for your great support. And yes, I appreciate your kind support. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.